ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शंकराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वंदे गुरुपरम्पराम् वंदे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पाद शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः समस्त जनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम्। हरिओम। ओम अखंडमंडलाकारं व्याप्तं येन चराचरं तत्पदं दर्शितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुदेवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव। श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। हरिओम। ओम वासुदेवेन्द्र योगींद्रं नत्वा ज्ञानप्रदं गुरुं मुमुक्षूणां हितार्थाय तत्वबोधोभिधीयते। भगवान शंकराचार्य जी ही सेइंग तत्वबोधः अभिधीयते। I am going to expound this truth. Tattva means truth. Why? Mumukshunam hitardaya. Those who want to liberate themselves for them, for their welfare, I am going to teach the text called Tattva Bodha. And he himself doing namaskar to his guru, Govinda Padacharya. Vasudevendra Yogindra means he is doing salutations to his guru and he is invoking his grace, then he is starting his journey. Why Swamiji, you know, when Pujya Gurudev, he visited Europe, one young boy, he met our Pujya Gurudev and straight he asked Gurudev, Chinmayananji, we have so many books on philosophy. why do we need a guru? Because we have so many books, why do we need a guru? Then Gurudev, in his own way, he replied, why don't you ask this question to the books? I know, you ask the books, you know, they cannot tell anything. That is knowledge, definitely. But to explain the knowledge, to teach knowledge, one sentient being we need. And he should have that experience of that truth. Shankaracharya is that one. So, first of all, he explained about the nature of jiva. See, he started the jiva at sthula shariram and he ended this jiva as atma, satchidananda swarupa atma. Means the tattva bodha of jiva is that satchidananda self. Tattva means the essence, the reality. The truth of each individual is nothing but that Brahman only. He concluded there. Then he started the inquiry about the world. He started world, started from space, space to air, air to fire, fire and so on. So Trigunatmaka, Sattva, Rajas, Tamo, Gunatmaka, everything he enumerated. But the essence of the world also Brahma. How can Swamiji? Because whatever you are saying, world names and forms and objects and being, this is all nothing but Maya only. Just an illusion, an appearance on the truth. As a snake is an appearance on rope, in the same way, all the names and forms and qualities, everything is an appearance on the Satchidananda Brahma. So the truth of the world also Brahma only, truth of the jiva also Brahma only. This is the way of teaching of Vedanta. They start the teaching where we are. And the end this teaching, what is the reality? So the reality is the Brahman. If you see the Jagat, the reality of the Jagat also Brahman. Or if you see your own self, the reality of myself also, the Satchidananda Brahmaswarupam. And the third one is Jiva, Jagat, the third one is Ishvara. Swamiji, in Vedanta, what is that one word definition for Ishvara? Because in Bhakti, we may say so many things, but in Vedanta, what will be the definition for Ishvara? You know, the one word answer is Ishvara is the Karana of Jiva and Karana for Jagat also. What is the cause for the entire universe? That is Ishvara. And what is the cause of me? From whom I came out? That cause, that Karana we can say as Ishvara. Then that Ishvara, so many things will be there. Today, Bhagavan, actual main teaching of Vedanta is Ishvara Jiva Abheda Jnana. Abheda means there is no difference between Ishvara and Jiva. Swamiji, what are you talking, Swamiji? How can be these two one? How can be these two are same? You know, Ishvara means very big body, big boss. I am very little, this jiva. I know my weaknesses. I know my limitations. I know my conditionings. I know my lifetime, Swamiji. How can I be the Ishvara? But Vedanta said, no, these two are one. That is called Advaita Jnanam, non-dual truth. This non-duality, these are not two, this is one only. So today, Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji, he is trying to explain that truth, the identity between Ishvara and Jiva. Beautifully, he explains what is Ishvara, what is Jiva, how these can be one and the same. See, this is in page number 85 in my book. The heading is Jiva and Ishvara. Heading is Jiva and Ishvara. This paragraph is very, very important paragraph. See, I read one line and I'll explain what Bhagavan is saying. He's saying, Sthula Sharira Abhimani Jeevaha Namakam. What do you mean by Jeeva? The answer is, page number 100. The answer is Sthula Sharira Abhimani. The main characteristic of the Jeeva is Sthula Sharira Abhimani. Yeah, we know this because we represent always as this physical body only. And we identify other people also as the physical body only. If Rama Rao Garu is there, I cannot see the Atma of Rama Rao Garu. I can see the physical form of the Rama Rao Garu. This is the main feature in Jiva's Lakshana. Sthula Sharira Abhimani. One, point one. Second, Brahma Pratibimbam. This Jiva, he is the reflection on Supreme Truth Brahma. Pratibimbam means reflection. This Jiva is Brahma Pratibimbam, Bhagavan is saying. He is the reflection of the truth. Okay. Then, see his characteristics. Sa Eva Jivaha. This Jiva, this boy, this man, this woman. Sa Eva Jivaha. Prakrutya. Prakrutya means because of the nature. Prakrutya means because of the nature. Svasmat. Svasmat means from him. Ishwaram bhinnatvena janati. Because of the nature, he himself treats, I am different from God. This is all Jiva's biography. Because of the nature, Jiva, he himself thinks, I am different from Ishwara. He thinks. And then, avidya upadihi san atma jiva iti uchyate. When the Supreme Satchidananda Parabrahma, if it conditioned by avidya, avidya upadhi, if it conditioned by avidya, ignorance, then the Supreme Brahman only will be called as Jiva. That's why they say this Jiva is not separate from Brahma. The separating factor between Brahma and Jiva is this ignorance, this avidya. This avidya itself is upadhi. His upadhi means his wealth. Because of this avidya, he himself is treating as a sthula sharira abhimani and I am different from Ishwara. See this power of the avidya. It is minimizing his glory. He says, Swamiji, Ishwara is very big, Swamiji. He is the Lord of the universe. I am not even the Lord of my house. Not even Lord of my family, my factory. So he always separates Ishwara from himself. This is Jiva. And the next line Bhagavan is saying, then who is Ishwara Swami? Maya Upadi San Ishwara Iti Uchyate. He defined Jiva as Avidya Upadi San Atma Jiva. Jiva's Upadi is Avidya. Whereas Ishwara also he has one upadhi, one conditioning. The name of the conditioning Maya. he used another word for Ishvara's condition. That is called Maya Upadhi San Ishvara Iti Ujjate. The same Brahman, when he is identifies himself with Maya, he will be called as Ishvara. The same Brahman, if he identifies with Avidya, he himself called as a Jiva. Okay, let us see. And he will explain what is Avidya, what is Maya. Why he used two terms. Ishvara. And see, now the main crux is there. Evam. Evam means in this way. Upadhi bhedat. Because of the conditionings. Upadhi bhedat. Because of the conditionings. Jiva Ishvara Bedha Drishtihi. The sight of difference. Drishtihi means the sight of difference between Jiva and Ishvara is because of this conditionings only. So what, Swamiji? Let there be conditionings. Let him in his own samrajya and let me in my own samrajya, my own kingdom. What is wrong? What is wrong with avidya? What is wrong with maya? What is wrong with conditioning, Swamiji? Let Ishvara, let him be there. Let Jiva, let be he be. He will be here. There is a problem. Bhagavan is saying, okay, what problem, Swamiji? Evat paryantam beda drishtihi tishtati tavat paryantam janma marana adi roopa samsaram na nivartate. What do you mean, Swamiji? As long as these differences are there, that is Ishvara and this is me, so long this samsara cannot be removed. The jiva will be a samsari only. What do you mean by samsara, Swamiji? Janma marana adi roopa samsara. The nature of the samsara is birth and death and so on. This is called samsara in Vedanta. Not beings and things. Means always we change our conditionings. Many people they ask, Swamiji, what is wrong with conditioning? Let them be there. One problem is they always change. Nothing is permanent. And moreover, they always one after one another will come and they continue. Swamiji, if the death happened, okay, the life is ended. No. Because you accumulated so many vasanas and you yourself treated as an enjoyer of the vasanas. To enjoy that vasanas, you need another body. So again, you will migrate into another body. And good karmas may be there, bad karmas. We don't know what we are accumulating when we are doing actions. Even punya karma also, some people, they get papam only. Why, Swamiji? Because they cannot see properly what is happening. They will be covered by their lenses. Through that lenses, they will see faults and failures only. So again, they will project the same sight on everything and they will bind themselves and they will limit themselves. So by chance, we got a chance to listen Vedanta and Sadguru and this Bhagavat Marga. So we are getting little knowledge. We may lose this chance also. Moreover, this Janana Marana cycle is a myth. It is a false valued thing. we are getting so much scared of snake, but the truth is there is no snake at all. So this is the power of the ignorance. Actions are bad or good, or they don't affect us. If we jump from the cycle of the ignorance, if we get the knowledge, then actions cannot bind us. The same actions, the same persons, the same situations, they don't do anything if you have the knowledge of yourself. Knowledge of what, Swamiji? Knowledge of who am I? Bhagavan Raman Maharshi, he used to teach. If somebody asked Bhagavan, please teach something, he used to say this much only. Please think, who are you? Sit quietly and think, who am I? First, you know, all our professional knowledge may come. I am doctor, I am engineer. Then question, really, I am a doctor or I am doctor? Doctor is my profession or it is my nature? No profession cannot be our nature. Then our people, I am father, I am son, I am wife, I am husband, our relations, then the next intact. You know, they all will change. And they all are related with this physical body only. I am a father because of this body, I am a son because of this body only. Then think, is the physical body me? It is completely inert. It doesn't know what it is. Then Swamiji, my nature, my personality, my mind, my thought structure, my vasanas, think of them. They always continuously change. Sometimes they say, I am so good man. The same thought after 10 minutes, they say, I am a bad man. That thought is good, that thought is bad. Definitely. That thought is holy, that thought is unholy. Definitely. But I am the substratum on whom all these thoughts are playing. That Shuddha Chaitanyam me. That is Janma Maranadi Rahita Vastu. Samsara Rahita Vastu. So this is the knowledge and ignorance, what we call trick. So Bhagavan is saying, Yavat Paryantam Bheda Drishtihi Bhavati Tavat Paryantam Janma Maranadi Rupa Samsaram Nani Vartate. As long as you think they are different, I am different, so long this samsara will be there. Therefore, the final conclusion Bhagavan is saying, Tasmat, Jiva Ishvara Beda Buddhihi Na Svikaryam. Because of this samsara vritti, we cannot accept. Jiva is different, Ishvara is different. I am different, you are different. These all differences are, as long as we think I am separate, so long the samsara will be there. This is the main. Now, Swamiji, you said, Ishvara and Jiva and both are same. Can you give some light on this, Swamiji? And the Bhagavan, he is going to give how we can say Ishvara Jiva are one. First of all, let me teach you, what do you mean by Ishvara in Vedanta? Because the same Ishvara, Sri Rama in Ramayana, Sri Krishna in Bhagavatam, some Prahalad Charitra, Rishimha is the same Ishvara. But Swamiji, in essence, what will be the nature? What are the characteristics of this Ishvara? Please listen. In all our Vedantic textbooks, the knowledge of Ishvara moves around these thoughts only. Okay, Swamiji. The first thought is, when Brahma identifies with Maya, Brahma plus Maya is equal to Ishvara. In Vedanta, who is God? Brahma plus Maya is equal to God, is equal to Ishvara. So if you remove Maya, then there will be no Ishvara, only Brahma. If you add Maya, then the same Brahma will be called as Ishvara. And then, Swamiji, this is the definition you said. What is the job of the Ishvara, Swamiji? With the association of Maya, what he is doing? What he is doing, Swamiji? He is going to parties, picnics. What is his job? Vedanta said he has three jobs. Three jobs? Yeah. The three jobs are creation, sustenance, and destruction. That's why in childhood they used to teach G-O-D, God. Generator, operator, and destructor. I used to remember always because it's something new. When we are so young, like 6th standard, 5th standard, they used to, G-O-D means generator, operator, and destroyer. In Vedanta also they are there. He is the creator of the universe, generator. He is the sustenance of the universe, operator. And one day, he is Layakara. Layakara means he dissolves all the creation. Like how we do every day in deep sleep. We dissolve all relations, personalities, good, bad, and everything. We will go to some other phase of life. That is called destruction. So Swamiji, what is the job of the Ishvara? Means this is the job of the Ishvara. Okay? Definition. Brahma plus Maya is equal to Ishvara. Job, generation, operation, and destruction is his job. These three only we call Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara in Puranic language. Okay, Swamiji. Then Swamiji, what all his powers? What is the greatness of Ishvara, Swamiji, and the entire? He has three powers. One power is, he is omniscient. Omniscient means he is sarvajna, all knower. Omniscient. Second one is omnipresent. Omnipresent means he is everywhere. Omniscient, omnipresent. And the third one is omnipotent. Omnipotent means all powerful. Sarvashaktiman. Sarvashaktiman means he can do whatever he wants to do. He can stop whatever he wants to stop. Sarvashaktiman means these three has to. He can do what he wants to do. He can stop what he wants to stop. And the third one is he can turn. He can turn how he wants to make it as. For example, we may think, let it be some way, some way, some way. If he thinks, if in another way, if he wants this thing, that is called another power of Sarvashakti. Sarvashaktiman means these three has to be there. They say, kartum, akartum, anyadha kartum, shaknum, Sarvashaktiman. Kartum means what he wants to do, he will do. Akartum means if he wants to stop anything, he can stop. Anyadha kartum means if he wants to change the direction, he can change the direction of the jagat. This is called Sarvashaktiman. Okay, Swamiji. Omniscient, omnipresent, and omnipotent. Sarvajna, Sarvavyapaka, Sarvashakti is Ishvara's powers. This is all about God, I am saying. Who is God? What is his job? What all his powers? Yes, Swamiji. And fourth one, Ishvara is both material cause and efficient cause for the world. I have told already when the topic of Jagat. Ishvara only appearing as a material cause, five elements. And Ishvara only has the knowledge of whole universe, efficient cause. How he did, what should be done, what is the law of here, what is the law here, what is the law of sun, what is the law of gravity, how this show should run. That efficient cause also he only, and the material cause also he only. This is the fourth characteristic of Ishvara. Four. Swamiji, four okay. But fifth one, I have a slight doubt, Swamiji. Swamiji, you said Ishvara is nothing but Brahma plus Maya. Does Maya can do anything to this Ishvara, Swamiji? Because Maya is nothing but mind. Mind can play so many tricks. This Maya can play with Ishvara, or what is their relation, Swamiji? Maya and this Ishvara, you know, Ishvara is Maya Dhisha. Maya cannot do anything to Ishvara. How, Swamiji? Why she cannot do anything? Because our Maya is doing so much things. Why his Maya is not doing anything? In our regular parlance, Maya is nothing but his wife. Ishvara's wife is Maya. Swamiji, my wife is, you know, but how he is controlling her wife all the time. Maya Dhisha, you are saying, how? You know, because his Maya is predominant with Sattva Guna. That's why Bhagavan Shankaracharya used Maya word. Whereas in Jiva case, he used Avidya. Avidya means predominance is Tamo Guna. Maya is predominance with Sattva Guna. So, Sattva Guna is nothing but, you know, lot of knowledge. Tamoguna is nothing but lot of ignorance. That's why we are not ready to know ourselves. Whereas the same Maya, it helps to Ishvara to know himself. That's why Ishvara is always aware of his true self. He knew who he is. Therefore, Maya cannot do anything. That's why he is Maya Dhisha. Prakritim Swam Adishtaya Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. In Bhagavad Gita, he says, hey Arjuna, you don't think this Prakriti can play with you, but it cannot play with me. Prakritim Swam Adishtaya. I control the whole nature and Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. I will burn again and again, sometime Rama, sometime Krishna, sometime Hiranya, Narasimha, whatever. This knack he got because of his knowledge. Maya Dhisha Ishvara. And one bhakti element we should know here. That is, if Jiva surrenders to this almighty Ishvara, he will help to this little Jiva to remove his ignorance and liberate himself. Maam eva ye prapadyante, mayam etam tarantite. Maam eva prapadyante. If anybody surrenders to me, I will help them to cross over this maya chakra, this mind magic, this dullness in the intellect. I will help them how to get the knowledge, how to practice the spirituality. And finally, they can reach me. The final destination is me only. Between him and me, this ignorance only playing, whether with the name of Vidya or Tamoguna or Sattvaguna, what it be. So he gave this promise. Mameva ye prapadyante mayametam tarantiti. That's why we cannot say Vedanta, Vedantin, he should not have any kind of bhakti. No, even we surrender to Gurudev. Because of his grace only we are getting little knowledge. We are getting a chance to, you know, reflect on the great truths of Upanishads. Now I cannot say, you know, completely I am disconnected with Guru or Shastra or Bhagavan. They should be there for our progress. Bhagavan, this is also one characteristic of Ishvara. We cannot ignore that. Maya, Adhisha, Triguna, Swarupa, so and so, Sarvajna, Sarvashaktiman, Sarvavyapaka. And the same time, if anybody surrenders to him, he will help this Jiva to liberate himself. So this is the complete biodata of Ishwara. Okay, Swamiji. Now, Swamiji, what is Jiva? Can you throw some light? The Jiva is completely reverse. What is that reverse, Swamiji? He is Sarvashakti, Sarvavyapaka, Sarvajna. This Jiva is Alpashakti, Alpavyapaka, Alpajna. Alpashakti means very little power we have. Alpajna means little knowledge only we have. Alpavyapaka means little space only we can, what we call Vyapaka. This is Jiva. Swamiji, why this difference, Swamiji, between Ishwara's Upadhis and Jiva Upadhis? Because of this Jiva, he is identified with Avidya. This Avidya is predominant with Tamoguna. This Tamoguna is nothing but ignorance. So in our structure, majority part is ignorance. In his structure, majority is knowledge. If we get knowledge, if we can remove our ignorance, then we also will be Brahman only. See, the power of ignorance and the power of knowledge. If we can remove our ignorance and if we endowed with pure knowledge, then we will also be Brahman only. So this is the main difference. Avidya means Tamogunatmika Ajnana. So because of this Tamoguna, he is Maya Dhisha, Lord of Maya. But we, Maya Dasa, servant of Maya. Maya means our mind only. We cannot yield our mind, my mind only. We cannot command our mind, even though it is mine. Yes, Swamiji. My guardian is not listening to me because of this ignorance. We don't know how to tackle it. We don't have answers for all its questions. That is called ignorance. Mind asks something, we give some wrong knowledge and it will take it as and it will take us to one place to another place. Gattar to gattar. This is all we don't have proper knowledge about mind, about me, about my true nature. That's why we become Maya Dasa. He is Maya Dhisha, Lord of Maya. So these two are the Jiva characteristics and Ishvara characteristics. Now, okay, Swamiji. Then Bhagavan said, Jiva is nothing but Brahma Pratibimba. Reflection of Brahman is this Jiva, you and me. Now, we are all reflections of Brahman. Pooja Guruji, he used to give always one example. Take a bucket of water. You know, in that bucket of water, the reflection of sun is there. You know, the magnitude of the sun is very big. The magnitude of the sun is very big. His power is very big. He is too far from where the bucket is. Even though, because of the water, there is a reflection. I know. In the same way, because of this upadhis, the reflection of Brahma will be happen. as the conditioning, so the reflection. If the water is muddy, then we cannot see the sun properly. If the water is plain, then we can see the Brahma properly. If the mind is pure, then we can see the Brahma Jnana clearly. If the mind is impure, then we cannot see the Brahman as pure. Because Upadhi itself is muddy. And it always thinks, you know, this reflection, I am conditioned by this bucket, I am conditioned by this bucket, one thing. And it says so many buckets are there. That is blue bucket, this is red bucket, this is black bucket, this is small bucket, this is old bucket, this is young bucket. This is all jiva knowledge. Because he is identifying with bucket. Stola sharira abhimani. So what he should do, Swamiji, he should know his true identity. I am not the reflection in this bucket. Actually seeing, my nature is completely different. I am light. My nature itself is a light. Whereas this water is jada, there is no light for itself. Because of me, it is shining. But I am thinking because of water, I am conditioning. He should know his real identity. Then he will come to know, Hare, I am the great Surya Bhagavan. Nothing to do with this bucket. Then we will kick the bucket and we will be liberated. Aina, the same. This Pratibimba knowledge is actually Shankaracharya used one word only, that's Brahma Pratibimba Jeev. There is a big vada in this, big science. What we are saying, names and forms and qualities and limitations, you know, these are all like different Pratibimbas of Brahma on different Upadhis. As long as these reflections identify with Upadhis, this plurality will be there, goodness will be there, badness will be there, greatness will be there, so many things will be there. If the reflection, if it knows its true identity, then nothing to do with these buckets. Because there is no connectivity between sun and water. Let it be this bucket, haito, haito, naito, nai. My glory is me. That is Brahma Jnana, sir. Actually, we don't like that thought in ourselves. Swamiji, I am a knowledgeable, okay. I am wise, okay. But you completely deny the structure. Vedanta wants that. We have to throw the bucket with water. Then we are supreme, infinite, one. So this jiva pratibimba, source is Shuddha Brahma. Guruji, he used one word. This struggle of jiva will end not by action, doing or not doing. Not by people, with or without. So Swamiji, when it will end, he has to know one thought. That is, I am what I am seeking. Everybody, we should know that. I am what I am seeking. Actually, we are seeking happiness outside, completeness outside, infinitude outside, ever existence outside. Outside means with body. No. What are you are seeking? Complete happiness, completeness, purnatva, infinitude. These are, you cannot get anywhere. These are all you. I am what I am seeking. Then we got the knowledge. Shuddha Surya Teja Swarupa me. Not the bucket, not the water, not the day, not the night. There is no day, no night. I am one. That is Brahma. This identity is expounded in Mahavakya called Tattvamasi. You may ask me, Swamiji, does Shankaracharya ji saying on his own, Ishvara and Jiva one, there is no duality, only Advaita Brahma, Ekam. On his own, he is explaining with his vocabulary and his wisdom because we don't know anything. Is there any proof, Swamiji, authentic proof? Yes. That is called Tattvamasi Mahavakyam. This Tattvamasi Mahavakyam in Chandogya Upanishad. We have main four Mahavakyams. We have that knowledge, Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, Ityadi. Among the four, we Advaitins, we strongly work on this Tattvamasi. Why, Swamiji? Tattvamasi only clearly saying, both are one. Which both, Swamiji? Tattvam Asi. Actually, in Tattvamasi Mahavakya, there are three words. A plus B plus C. What are the three words, Swamiji? Tat plus Tvam plus Asi. Together, Tattvam Asi. Tat means Ishvara. Tvam means Jiva. Asi means same. Asi means same. So clearly Upanishad is saying there is no duality, only one. Ishvara and Jiva are one and one and one. Tattvamasi. In the Upanishad, the Guru is Svetaketu. Guru is Buddhalaka and Shishya is Svetaketu. And there is a beautiful story. This Buddhalaka is father and Svetaketu is son, actually. This son is little arrogant, this boy. He doesn't want to go to school. He is with his mother only when he is child, always in kitchen, eating and enjoying mother. And his father used to insist him, go to school and learn. Every day you should go to school. Somehow he sent him to Gurukula, school. This Vatiketu, he went to school and the teachers were so brilliant. They taught so many shastras, Vyakarana, Chandas, Jyotisham, this Vidya, that Vidya, so many Vidyas, Upasana, everything they taught. And Svetaketu, little grown up, 21 years something, he came back from Gurukula. He was graduated from the school, from the college, and he came back to his house. He did namaskaram to his father. And in Upanishad, it is there, he stood straightened. Matlab, he did not bend down in front of his father after studies. His father did not like it because if anybody, he was graduated from university, he should be humble. He should be good. He should not be arrogant. His father did not like. And his father asked this, Uddalaka asked this son, Svetaketu, Svetaketu, did you learn everything? He said, yes, of course, I learned everything. Okay. Did you learn anything supreme knowledge? He asked, supreme knowledge, what do you mean by supreme knowledge, my father? And he said, did you have any knowledge about Brahma, Paramatma? You know, the answer from Svetaketu is, I think my father, my teachers doesn't know that knowledge. That's why they did not taught me. They did not teach me. Then his father, this is the answer itself, saying he is so arrogant. He is saying, my teachers doesn't know. That's why they did not teach me. Then he said, okay, Svetaketu, still Baki is there. Now I have to take charge. Because if you don't know this knowledge, you will be zero. Whether fool, a big fool, small fool, fool is fool only. Aina? Kasmin no bhagavate, what we should know to liberate or they say, what if we know something, then everything will be known. That will be the Brahma Vidya. He said, you know, you are a big fool, that's all. Then he taught this knowledge with this Mahavakya Tattvamasi 9 times in Chandogya Upanishad. 9 times he teaches. He says, Swetaketu, get one salt piece and put it in the water and, you know, stir it. Now check where is the salt. He says, there is no salt, my daddy. Then he said, Tattvam Asi. Salt is also water, water is also water, but it has one name and form and quality and taste and everything. If it mix with its own identity, it will lose everything and it will be one with water. Tattvam Asi, Swetaketu. And he takes 9 examples. Then he understood what is the reality. Completely he drops all his conditionings. No bucket, no water, no quality. Nothing to do with these conditionings. I am the Shuddha Akhanda Ananta Brahma. Not this I, that pure one I. That is called Tattvamasi Mahavakyam. And many people, Bhagavan, next question, he says, they don't accept this. Even in philosophies also. In Advaita philosophy only we say complete liberation, meaning we should be Brahma only. Swamiji, as a Dasa, I will be in Vaikuntha. Still you are not liberated. You may be great. Swamiji, I will go to Goloka. Swamiji, I will go to Saketa Loka. Swamiji, I will go to Indra Loka. Swamiji, I will go to Brihaspati, Guru Loka. Even though you are a limited being. But your conditionings may be big, may be great, may be sattvic, may be holy. Still they are conditionings only. The complete solution is this Brahma Vidya. You have to drop all upadhis. That Shuddha Chaitanya Rupam only Moksha Rupam. That plus anything, then you will be conditioned by something. They don't accept many philosophies because they don't like this. How can you deny that, Vaikuntha Loka? How can you deny this Shiva Loka, Kailasha Loka? How can you deny with Parvati, Maya Devi, Sarvaloka Samragni, Maha Chakra, Maha Tejaswati, Shaktivati? She will punish you. She may punish me, but the truth is truth. Her reality, my reality, one only. She is powerful. I am not powerful. My conditionings are not powerful because of something. But the truth is one. That says this Tattvamasi Mahavakya. And Bhagavan Shankaracharya, he concludes this Tattvamasi Mahavakya or the identity between Jiva and Ishvara with a beautiful way. That is actually orthodox way of explaining this Tattvamasi Mahavakya. Now, you have to be little careful. Careful, little attentive. He gave small knowledge only, little knowledge only. If you go to Vedanta Panchadesi, then we can expound more. But here in Tattva Bodha, whatever Bhagavan he spoke, I will explain about Tattvamasi Mahavakya and how it is referring the identity between Ishvara and Jiva. Now listen attentively, please. See, 3 words are there in the Tattvamasi Mahavakya. They are, in Tattvamasi Mahavakya, 3 words will be there. They are Tat plus Tvam plus Asi. Okay? And the second one is they are saying, Tat is Ishvara. Tvam is Jiva. Asi is both are same. Okay. Next, my question is, Swamiji, why Tat Ishvara Tvam Jiva? Is there anything behind this? Because Tat means that. Always we keep Ishvara as remote. Hai na? Always we keep Ishvara as remote, something different from me. In all ways. That's why this Tat is referring for Ishvara. And if somebody asks, who are you? Me. So Tvam is Jiva. Asi means both are same. Now we ask. Just now you said, Swamiji, he is Maya Dhisha. Sarva Shakti, Sarva Shakti, Sarva Vyapaka Vikti. And Sattvika Gunavan, Mahajnani. Whereas Jiva is Maya Dasa. He cannot control even his mind. How can these two equal? Now, this orthodox saying is, listen. For every word, there will be two indications in Sanskrit. One is called Vachyardha. Vachyardha means literal meaning. Literal meaning. The second one is called Lakshyardha, implied meaning. For every word, it will be there. For example, one word I will say. The red is running. The statement is, the red is running. The literal meaning, if you take, you cannot apply because red cannot run. Red is a color, it cannot run. But the literal meaning, it says the red is running means the color, as though the color is running. The implied meaning, do you know, there is one word missed. That is, the red horse is running. Because that's a great, big horse race, so many horses are there. Red is there, black is there, white is there, blue is there. But this man wants to say the red horse is running. So this is implied meaning. But the word meaning is as though if you don't understand, you may think the red color is running. In India, they say in Indian English, my house is on the beach. We use that way. In Bombay, Vishakhapatnam, in our town, my house is on the beach. Then the man, if he is completely don't know what I am speaking, he may think, oh, his house is on the beach, floating on the water. No, my house is on the beach means my house is next to beach. That is called implied meaning because we cannot stay on ocean, next to beach. Here also, in Tat Tvam, the word meaning is, if you take the word meaning, Ishvara means Brahma with so many conditionings. Jiva means Brahma with little conditionings. With conditionings, these two cannot be same. Asi cannot be applied. So, the Rishi is saying, see the Ishvara without conditionings. See the Jiva without conditionings. I am not saying the word meanings of Ishvara and Jiva. The conditionings, if we put the conditionings only, we can say that is Ishvara with so big, Jiva is so small. I am not saying from that standpoint, you cannot see the identity. So what I am meaning is, remove the conditionings, then the Asi is there, that is called Shuddha Chaitanya. Ishvara also starts from I only. Jiva also starts from I only. I plus is different for Jiva. I plus is different for Ishvara. Whether it is a knowledge and ignorance, powers, and our capacities. These are all conditionings only. So the Rishi, what he wants to say is, remove all the conditionings, and what is the background? That is same. In this way, Ishvara and Jiva one. That is called Tattvam Asi. Here we can identify with the one truth. That is called Tattva Bodha. Remove the buckets, remove the waters and their qualities. Automatically the shadow, you know, it cannot say I am the shadow in the water because you are the light of the light. That Shuddha Surya, the Brahma, me. This way, Ishvara and Jiva one. Advaita. Then Swamiji, what is going to happen to this Maya and Avidya, his wife and my wife? What they are going to do? Don't worry. Why? They are not there anytime. So there is no need to worry. If something is really ghost is there, then we can scare, no doubt. Actually, ghost is not there. This is post only. You know, Gurudev used to say, one man, he is coming from the movie, second show movie, means midnight movie. So on the way, he is coming alone. The roadside, there is a big ghost is there. And in a second, he has seen everything. Swamiji, big eyes, Swamiji, it is roaring, Swamiji, it's white kapada, Swamiji, completely, ghost. Many people have come. Arey, we have never seen. Since the last 30 years, we are staying in the street only. There was no ghost at all. How can today it came? Ghost. Everybody came and they switch on the light. That is not ghost, that is post. So we need not worry what is going to happen to this Maya and Avidya. This is all knowledge. If we get the knowledge, then the one will be one always. It cannot become two or it cannot become many. This is called Tattvamasi Mahavakya Bodha. With this, Bhagavan is completed his teaching. So we should stay in our own true nature. Who reflected on this thought, who understood this thought, and who is living as Brahman, they are called Jivan Mukta Purusha. Moksha Purusha. That may be Sadguru, that may be Santa Mahatma, that may be Sri Rama, that may be Sri Krishna. And next class, Bhagavan is going to tell about him. Jivan Mukta Purusha. With that, he will complete this Tattva Bodha text. Hari Om. Om. पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांतिः हरिः ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः।